towering lava fountains reaching more than 600 meters or 2,000 feet into the sky. A lengthy lava flow that is advancing towards a populated area, and heavy ashfall completely coating the nearby ground in a layer of fine gray particles. This might sound like I am describing 2021's Cumbre Vieja eruption in Spain's Canary Islands, but rather I am actually describing a particular 1793 eruption which occurred in Mexico. This eruption did not originate from one of the nation's many famed stratovolcanoes, but rather occurred at a type of volcano which is quite rare in the country, a shield volcano. Specifically, at the San Martin Tuxtla volcano, whose summit is located 18 kilometers north-northwest of the city of Catemaco. The reason I am mentioning this city is that between 3600 and 1800 years ago, a series of three volcanic eruptions occurred right next to what is now a modern population center, building three cinder cones. As you might have guessed from the location of these vents far away from San Martin's summit, many of this volcano's eruptions occur on its flanks. This is why there are several hundred visible flank vents consisting of cinder cones and less common but not always lake-filled more explosion craters. While this volcano has shown no signs of life since its last eruption more than 200 years ago, the fact that an eruption occurred so recently in 1664 and 1793 are proof that San Martin is still active and will likely erupt again one day. The good news is that San Martin seemingly erupts at a low rate, averaging about once every 900 years. But why does this volcano exist? Exactly what happened during its unusually explosive 1793 eruption, and how long has it been erupting for? To start off, like the vast majority of the nation's active volcanoes, San Martin Tuxtla is located within a volcanic chain known as the Trans-Mexican Volcanic Belt. These volcanoes exist due to the distant subduction of the Cocos Plate underneath the North American Plate. The melted material from this collision then migrates upwards, intruding into the crust, which sometimes results in eventual eruptions, forming a chain of volcanoes. In the case of the vicinity surrounding the modern San Martin Tuxtla volcano, volcanic activity has been intermittently ongoing for nearly 7 million years, building a series of now extinct volcanic edifices to the southeast. While some of these volcanoes were active up until 1.5 million years ago, it appears that San Martin didn't truly begin to form until 800,000 years ago when its first eruption occurred. We really don't know much about this shield volcano's geologic history, so what I'm about to present involves a combination of several educated guesses and speculation. During the early stages of San Martin's growth, eruptions seemingly occurred along a northwest to southeast trend between the Santa Coma Pan Fault and the Catemaco Fault. Numerous, mildly explosive eruptions occurred on loosely connected ridges, revealing localized faults, constricting cinder cones, erupting tephra, and creating distinct lava flows. Over time, eruptions built a raised more than 40-kilometer-long ridge, with the easternmost and westernmost ends of this eventually becoming inactive. Eruptions eventually began most frequently occurring within a central region, which over time created a shield-shaped edifice from overlapping lava flows. This centralized region has become more dominant over time, but even in recent times appears to be responsible for less than half of San Martin's Holocene eruptions, of which there have been 13. Highly explosive eruptions occurred when rising magma interacted with bodies of groundwater, resulting in the generation of large explosions that create the dozens of Mars spread across San Martin's flanks. And now, here is San Martin's record of historical eruptions. There was allegedly a flank cinder cone and lava flow forming eruption in 1532, but rather this eruption even ever truly happened is up for debate. An eruption in 1664 was moderately explosive and occurred on the southeast flank. In 1793, a phreatomagmatic eruption began at San Martin's summit as a fissure began explosively ejecting ash and lava. Significant fragmentation of rising magma occurred for multiple months, generating at times a more than 30,000-foot-high eruption column. Activity then shifted towards a violent Strombolian eruption, which formed two summit cinder cones, lava fountains, and an advancing lava flow to the north. This eruption became less explosive over time, and lava would continue to erupt at a declining rate until 1795. By the end of this VEI-4 eruption, 200 million cubic meters of ash had been emplaced, and a lava flow which had covered up to 2.24 square kilometers advanced as much as 3,500 meters to the north of San Martin's summit. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and YouTube channel members for supporting my work.